And welcome everybody here to the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament! It has been some days since we had our last game, but we're finally back here. And we have a good one here. We have Hail United against EED, aka Internal Envy's Disciple here. This is the lower bracket, round number one. As well, both teams are here. Finally, they had a little bit of a problem as Blaze was still in the game. But they're at least able to get everybody in for now. They have received a draft penalty, level 3. For the people that don't know that, your entire reserve time is just completely gone. So you have to make decisions like snap, 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 do it. And well, that's what they're doing right now. And they just well, this is already the really interesting picks from them. This is not something you see in the first phase actually coming out. A Beastmaster and Invoker. That's absolutely no first. First phase picks. It's pretty comfortable. Invoker against Shadow Fiend on mid. Yes, yeah, it's a pretty common matchup. At least for the pups. Like, professionally, you don't see Invoker enough. But simply put, Invoker is okay-ish. Defendable, depends on the build he goes. If he goes for Quartz Wax, you can get those early alacrity. Maybe have one port in Exhort, and you should be able to farm it up pretty easily. Same time, when Shadow Fiends get some levels, you know, it raises. This just takes up everything anyway. So it's fine. You know, it should be pretty even, or kind of depends on the rotations in. You'd sometimes see the offlane invoke or the safe lane, but I don't think that's the way you want to go here. Beastmaster as well. It should most likely be their offlane. There's still a possibility to run this as a support position 4. A little bit hard to get your items up, but still can be pretty potent, as well, just have these axes that you can still take to the Asians if you need to. You can always farm it back up as a position 4 or, you know, position 3. There's some ways to do that. Usually is played more with maxing out his summons and putting an early point into his passive to get some more attack speed going the way of his team. Just go for this more zoo-oriented build on the Beastmaster. As for you, did I pick up the Bane? Just a pretty common pick at the moment. Just a strong lane support as well. This high nuke and the control that comes out from him with this Fiend script is really hard to deal with. Sometimes they do have a tornado, which can easily take just take off the Fiend script. It can just easily stop it. It's not too hard to do, and yeah, something to keep an eye on there. They might be looking at a little bit more AoE stun for the side of here, just to make it easier to stop that. Shouldn't be too hard, as EED they've been out a Lichen and dying, just taking out some more lane control there. And just strong overall laners, trying to weaken the laning phase of Hey. Also want to remind everybody, this is the charity tournament for Save the Children. We have a stream tip open where you can go, streamtip.com/t/SwissDC_EN. Make some donations there, we'll show them all up on the screen. And yeah, just really do that, that's awesome. As well as just, it's also in the panels. You can also go to the Save the Children website, savethechildren.org, and put in some donations over there. It's always nice. We see some gap closer here for Juggernaut. Juggernaut, he's the gap closer in the Beastmaster, what I meant to say. Sometimes you can have troubles getting up close to someone, but this time around should be pretty easy. Roar will most likely secure that he can just run in, or even the tornado as well. Also, a really strong hero against Shadow Fiend, just doesn't really tend to have a way to escape. I think Shadow Fiend at the moment is already forced to go into a Yule Scepter build, just to save himself. So yeah, having all of that said here, ED, they have more than enough time to just carefully think about everything, and they will. So, let's see, so far they have a Bane, a Shadow Fiend, Tiny is still in the pool, hero that's commonly picked up, IO has been taken out, but still, even the just a casual Tiny is something that happens. My mic has some noise, I was not expecting that, give me a second to check that. Really fast. Oh yeah, I see it. Fuck. Okay, I'm sorry about that. It was still in CSGO settings. So yeah, sorry about my CSGO usually puts it to 100. I don't know why Source does. Source 1 does that to me. I put it down to where I normally have it. I'm really sorry about that. So okay, and he did go for the Winter Wyvern here, just getting some well, some saving mechanisms against the Juggernaut. I'm kind of surprised he didn't go for the Dazzle here, as they don't really have anything to stop that. Even though you call them Razor One, they're still an Evoke who can do a bunch of magical damage dependable on this build. And the Beastmaster is completely magical though, but yeah, Juggernaut is a complete physical force. Juggernaut, yeah, he can spin not the most damage, but can still kill you through Golden Blaze. Yeah, hey United, they are fully into the physical so far. Just really only Invoker to deal any real kind of magical damage. With the Dazzle now finally, yeah, it's gonna be big of a head. Like, it's, this hero can save you so hard. I don't know if ED are like trying to get this setup going here and maybe pick up something themselves now.
10 seconds remaining.
You know, maybe pick up an axe. You know, in the early game, it's kind of hard remaining for him against the Dazzle, because every time you walk up to creeps, you get Shadow Waved and you lose like about 200 HP every pop, maybe 180 dependable on that. Just a little bit dependable on how many creeps are there in the end. Having that said, it's in the mid game, Dazzle just gets completely countered out by Axe. He can just dunk, 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 and nothing Dazzle can really do about it. That's it, ED. They go for the more common build up. Pick up the Darkseer here. So the Winter Wyvern Darkseer combination is gonna be real. You have a Requiem on top of there as well. So it's gonna be really, really hard to deal with. They do need a position 1 hero. Yes, we'll most likely start to ban something around in those lines. Maybe an Anti-Mage, Spectre, there's a lot of things they can go to. I think they will let Spectre through. Anti-Mage, they do have some lockdown, but it's not the best. Yeah, same goes for an Ember, that's also so hard for them to deal with. So just take out the Ember here, it does mean that the Anti-Mage is in the pool, which is a pretty good pickup here. I guess they only really have to roar to keep you down for a long time. Invoker doesn't really have anything to keep you down, so. And the poison touch from Dazzle is not really too impressive either.
5 seconds remaining.
So let's see what's gonna be less pickup for head. I have one support left here. Yeah, the disruptor is gonna be banned out. It would have been a pretty safe pickup for her. Now they're gonna be forced into something else. There are a lot of supports already gone. They could try and stack up some minus armor in the form of maybe the Vengeful. It's a solid stun. It's pretty dodgeable by a lot of things, but still, it offers some utility as well to the team. So yeah, pretty much most of these supports have already been taken out, so I wouldn't mind the Vengeful if they will need to pick up something. They have 3 seconds left before it randoms, and they just go for the Rubik. Okay, also pretty good pickup here, and ED, they just completely answer back with the Brewmaster. This is gonna be the Brewmaster middle here. And then put yeah, maybe just Brewmaster mid and then put Shadowfiend on safe lane. Like, there are like some ways they can run this. I'm surprised they didn't pick up something more greedy. Actually here, so let's see how they're gonna run this. There are a lot of ways to do this. It really, really surprises me there is no Anti-Mage or something more elusive than the Brewmaster. We were expecting something different there. Some kind of DC. Oh my god. I'll give them the answer to that in the game. Okay, everybody, pick their heroes. I will need to look it up real fast. I actually forgot the name of it. I did know the cakes that he's talking about. Okay, we're gonna be unpausing and we're going into the game right now, so. Both sides are ready to go at it here. This is the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. And I want to remind everybody that this is for Save the Children. It's a charity organization that well, helps our children all around the world. All I can say is just make sure that you donate to them either directly or to us. You can do it to us at streamtip. .com/t/swissdc_en and ooh, I think they spot this one. Maybe I with Master Ricks here. Well, they're all gonna walk in. Germany's on the front. They're trying to bait something here with her, but okay. streamtip.com/t/swissdc_en or go to savethechildren.org. As this is the lower bracket, round number one between EED and Hair United, and Hair is just going in aggressive here, looking for some kind of pickup.
30 seconds to battle.
But they're not gonna find it. EED are properly fending out and not really giving them a chance to do anything. They did get the ward down here for the side of Pehe. But Mesterix, he knows it and he's gonna find it. Taking it out immediately. Too obvious for them. They will get the top rune still here and the bottom rune will still go the way of EED, of course.
The battle begins.
And we get a pass. So, one from ED. Oh. I think he did something something wrong. He will be taking it out soon. As everybody just starts to move out again and we'll be into the game right now. It's going to be the Shadow Fiend mid and it's actually going to be the farming Brewmaster here. Well, that's something I haven't seen lately, to be really honest. There's some ways to really go around it. Like, you can go for this Brew, like, Blink there was always normal, and then go for a Flats plus AC and you become this really physical damage heavy oriented core still. Even though you're Brew, you have pretty good passive. In the Drunken Brawler, as well as just having Drunken Haste, that can help out so much. Really annoying, I guess, any kind of physical damage coming out from the side of Hei, at least physical right click carries. I might even opt to go for the Exhort build on the Invoker. He has 1 point in it, but I'm not sure if he's gonna go for the Exhort Quas build or go for the Wex Exhort. Oh, no, he is going full on Exhort build. He at least picks up an early Sunstrike for now. Maybe to help out somebody if they're gonna go for any kind of kills around the map. Some bottom McGraw is gonna be up against a dual lane. He's not alone, of course, he has Mesterix with him to help him out. At the same time, Pelican and as well as German player are just trying to make sure that McGraw can't get too much here. Already put him another point in Drunken Brawler here as well. Wouldn't mind seeing Drunken Haze level 4, I would say. Would be pretty nice. Would be really annoying to deal with. They're trying to get something going here. Pelican is taking a lot of damage. There comes the Earth Slap on the ground. Pelican has to start running away. He's pretty slow, but he's going to be fast enough right now. And now Mesterix is going to be turned on, though. German, he gets the kill there at the same time. He has to start running away. Celery has come in. He has a nightmare on Pelican right now. And he's trying to run away. There's level 1 Brainstep. He's not doing enough damage. As German just keeps on running and running. Can need another Tangle soon. Still some regeneration on top of him. But at the same time, Pelican finally comes in. And now Mesterix also come back. He's looking for German, but German is too fast. 14 seconds before he can go and Arctic burn him to slow him up, and it's not gonna work. He's gonna escape. He even picks up a bounty room for his troubles and to maybe buy up and some kind of item in the base. Could even buy a new new TP as well. Goes for the orb. Same time, HWA on top against Maui. Darkseer versus Juggernaut. We have seen it a couple of times already. It's pretty much kind of like even. Like, you can't really get a kill on the Darkseer. Apart if you can telekinesis him up in the middle of his search. Same time. He can't really kill you either. You have a healing ward. I already put an early level into it, as you can see. To just help him out and sustain throughout all the damage that's coming from them. Raw here, he's doing fine. 11-4. He's actually pretty out less hitting this side of here. Not really taking up the big advantage here, but it's so hard to be a melee hero against this boar spam coming out from German. does have only one for the upcoming 25 minutes, so maybe if they can kill it really fast, they have some kind. Ash is going to be a little bit more in their favor, but it doesn't really seem they can commit for it. Wouldn't mind seeing Stout Shield right now in German. Just help him out a bit with the sustain as well. We're just taking reduced damage. Will help him out a lot. It's all the same to me. It's the mid lane here so far, yeah. Not really able to stop Charlie here. 17 CS against the 14 on Blazeman. It's gonna be going for either an early threats, which would extremely surprise me as there's not an item commonly picking up on the invoker, or go for the Midas, which seems to be more the common build. He went back for the point in the wax, so it's gonna be the Quell's Wax build up here, just to get it with just an early point in next sword to just get this early alacrity going. German is gonna be found by Charlie though. Easy race, gonna be a kill for him, some extra souls for him as well. So far it's been a pretty slow paced game at the moment, both sides just trying to farm it up. Yeah, there's no orb. You can't really put your orb on top of him right now, Mario, so he's just needing to just eat all the duress coming out. HWA just spinning to kill up the creep wave here, pushing it forward. Went for the soul ring builds, just so he can put out the ward all the times. It's now an aggressive movement from Grawl, and he gets up the the Earth Slam here, but it's not gonna be too much. And oh, there comes out the Sunstrike, but it's gonna be off to Mark. Golden Race was cast before, and he was not expecting that. They need to pay with a lot of the Beastmaster so far. Pelican is now also running away. Yeah, not enough mana, nor the time for the Nightmare here. So he will be fine. And Grawl will survive, though. So, settling down again after some a little bit of aggressive movements. Blaze not having the easiest of times here, but this still, he's okay CSing. Like 23 is, he's a bit behind the Shadow Fiend, but the just a raw physical damage from Shadow Fiend makes it hard as well. Just keep having this creep wave every time underneath your tower is just no fun. Just no fun at all for you. Let's see what they're gonna get going. It's mostly for top here. Doesn't have any boots. Can buy one though if he wants to. I think that would be pretty pretty casual as well. Good pickup for Pelican here. Maybe he's trying to get to the side shop and get it from there. Rubik seems to be going on either a warding mission or a ganking mission. So far it will just be a ward. This one's put in an unusual place. Not really see this one too often. We'll just put one back here with Celery. I don't think he was spotted. No, he was spotted out of course, but the with the ward they placed up onto the Asians before. Oh, I don't think they really want to go into this. Nightmare put on Nihis, but there's not going to be any kind of follow-up, so he will just be left there for a couple of seconds. This ward was straight up pinged out by the side of ED, so they know it. They will probably be dewarded fairly soon, at least once Mesterix has enough gold for the sentries. As Celery is just casually still up mid, taking up some experience. Question is, do they have any stacks going? One double stack, two double stacks, and that's gonna be it so far for the Shadow Fiend. HWA, he has the Omni Slash. So if he can catch Mario off guard and just jump on him without any creeps there, he can easily kill him off. He has the Mango to give him the burst mana. Plus a Soul Ring if needed. Trying to go with a gank here, but it was completely spotted out by the ward coming out from EED. So they're trying to look for Charlie here, but I don't think they can find him. Maybe they can find a stack, but I think they already took it out. Yes, they did. Nothing really for them to do here. They should probably just go out from here. HWA even comes in as well. Are they going for a tier 1 push and button? They're rotating in so many heroes right now. There's no other choice for them to go than bottom and go for the tier 1 push. Pretty heavy investment from them. They're already going back to the base. We'll just take a stack though for now. It's not really enough. This is not worth it, simply put. They need to get more out of this 5-man rotation towards bottom than just stealing a double stack. They're missing out so much gold at the same time. The Darkseer on top is having a great time. And they go into the clap used here by McGraw. He's going on Pelican. Pelican does have a shallow grave, and his Brown Spit is just going to be committed here. Goes after German, and at the same time, they're going underneath the tower here. It's not going to work. They need to run past it and look for more. Pelican put in the air. Still has a shallow grave. He can use it if he wants to, but he can't get it off. That's the problem now. The double race comes out. So while doing a lot of damage to Blaze, but he's just going to survive on the nick of HP here. Same time, HWP is not able to kill off anybody and just runs straight into McGraw with a Thunderclap. As it just turned disastrous for him. They're just losing so much. They just got a Bane back, but the Bane has absolutely no net worth to speak of right now. So lows on net worth, and they lose HWA, their top farmer, and so also Dazzle. At the same time, like I said before, Moi is just farming on top. He's just doing okay. Like, I don't care. It's all fine by me. He's just having a good time there. It's Dire's top tower is under attack. Nothing really to some right now. HWA came back to top, so he just goes back to base and heals up, and then we'll go back there again. So that really does need some love. He needs level 6. That's the thing they need during the spin to just keep him in place. One thing is though, if you're a Bane, it kind of gets easily stolen by Nihis on the Rubick, and he will go and die now. Blaze just picking up this easy kill. Already has his Midas as well, so he's doing pretty fine. Oh, McGraw, he's gonna be doven here, and he's just taking a lot of damage. Sunstrike comes out, but this is actually pretty damaged. What the hell is this build? Okay, he went back for a sword. As said, he picks up a double kill. He is just really throwing me off the game with the shit he's doing right now. So he went back for the Exhort build. He went disappointing Wex to get the early Alacrity to help him farm, but not to go into this full build there. He can also throw a small tornado. And small. Oh my god, this is just so small. Level 1 Wex tornado. It's ridiculous. It's really, how big is it? It shouldn't be too much, like 800 distance. It's absolutely nothing. Also, the meteor is not too big either, so. They're looking for a rotation here on HWA. They have no level 6 on Bane. There's no more spin on HWA though. He does have an Omni off of cooldown in 2 seconds. One. With no Finch Grip here, Mori can just die here. He can just jump in and he will take a lot of damage. Is there gonna be Vacuum? Yeah. Nice level 2 Vacuum. Not enough damage. He just steeps out. Not even gonna run into the Sunstrike over there. Nice try there from him, but this puts in the end just the Omni Slash on cooldown. Not really getting the worth out of there. As I'm still wondering to think of the name, what it was again. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And now I need to make them fucking breakfast as well, so you want me to. Well, I mean, that's it. Mid lane in the end, it's exactly even. The net worth from the two heroes is the same. It's gonna be the mech build up for Charlie here. Either they want to push early or just want to stop the early push coming out from there. They can pretty much just do any of the things. Just nice item there. HWA will take the tower here. Maui wasn't able to deny it. So, McGraw, he should be getting closer to his Blink Dagger right now. It doesn't really have the fastest of time, but did go back from the bottle as well as the threats. So he has some early sustain there. Gonna be the Necro build up here for German. Just needs a little bit more gold for the recipe. He's actually pretty farmed. I don't think he has boots. Yeah, he just has brown boots, so nothing too special there. Really, with this Sol Ring build, he can just keep on spinning and spinning and spinning. Pretty crazy. Are they going for some kind of aggressive? This ward, it surprised me though that it hasn't been dewarded. I thought they pinged on it like 6 minutes ago. But okay. See, like, at the moment, he is really just all over the map, just taking farm everywhere. They're gonna try and go for something aggressive here. There's a level 6 up on Beastmaster, has level 1 Necrobook as well as. Well, the Ward pretty much ready. Nice is there as well. He's level 6, he instantly steals the Plinter Best, doesn't really help him with the skill. That said, the Sunstrike from Blaze does. Dominating streak on him already. They're really just doing so well right now. But it seems like ED want to take a fight here. McGraw does have a split. He will need to just pop it right there and right now before he gets killed. ED Charlie, he comes in, gets off the Wrecking, trying to get the damage in the throw up. Blaze He needs to get out of here, but he doesn't. Oh, ho, ho, in the nick of time here. Pelican gets off the shallow grave. He will die in the end here in the back lines. They're trying to fight it up there. Maurice is keeping them out. Blaze goes Infis. They have raises. Oh, raise one. Not gonna connect. Does have the bottle. Raising. Oh, TPing out. Oh, Evoker is gonna make it. Blaze. The play here. He is out. Same time, HWA, he came in as well. He does have a Sorin, but he pops at the straight same time that he gets put into the curse. Couldn't get up the Omni Slash there. Oh, that sucked so much for him over there. If he could have gotten off, he could have maybe turned it around a bit. Doesn't work in the end. German is still running away, but I don't think Mario can really find him. He might find Knees here. Vacuum comes out, but there's not going to be enough follow-up. Took a pretty hefty damage there from the Splinter Blast, but doesn't bring him low enough. And low enough is, of course, lower than 0 HP to kill him off, as they're not going to dive underneath the tower. Top lane. Man, this aggression between creeps should be illegal. No one is there to really farm it up either. But look, and he's... Okay, it seems to be an early agonist for him. This is going to be fun. He can just throw out spells all the time. So it was just, you know, a bit of sass, you know, makes you more tanky and all the good stuff. So it was great. Big question is right now, what's HWA going? Okay, he's going for the more common build-up right now, the Battle Fury. See more and more enjoyment. It's not really an especially great Battle Fury game, but it's still a pretty nice item. Just helps you farm as well. You know, there's some spirits, you know, getting some cleave on that. Just the physical damage against those heroes. I guess those heroes against the spirits is really, really nice. They're gonna look for some kind of initiation here. Oh, HWA, he's found. They're trying to burst him down in time, but there's comes out the Shadow Grave, and he's just gonna survive through the entire Fiend's Grip. He can turn this one around if he wants to with the Omni Slash, and he gets it off in the nick of time. Requiem is gonna be cancelled here by Charlie. He's not really able to get it off with the Cold Stamp going through on top of him. McGraw is also gonna fall. Charlie is gonna take a fall here as well. They lose 4 on the side of ED. Hehe, lose 0. Nice Shadow Grave. As well with the Cold Snap coming out on the perfect timing here to just save the retreat for HWA. He came back now. They're gonna keep on going. Are they going for Roshan or just returning? I would say they should just return. But wait, honestly, you never know. And it's gonna be... They're gonna try Roshan. There is no sustain on HWA. As he needs his healing ward right now. And sustain, of course, I mean the Morning Mask, so not the easiest there. That said, they have more than enough minions, as well as just Pelican on the Dazzle. Putting out the heals. They have the healing ward now as well. Roshan is low, under 1k, it's down. They're gonna pick it up, they're gonna give it to Blaze. He has this dominating streak on him right now, so don't want to give it away too easily. As well as you can just go aggressive right now with the Invoker. He should be pretty close to the... he had just 40 gold. And he has the axe. This is really early axe. 70 minutes. It's not really the usual build-up you see. You tend to see like some kind of mobility item. You know, even... Or just a Nules, Blink, Force, whatever. Anything along those lines. First item, axe? It's pretty unusual. Nias. He's going back for the 4-step though, so they're gonna have some 4-steps. So yeah, but at the same time, they're not too scared, they're just going for the tier 1 push here on top. They have McGraw ready with the split. They're gonna get the deny! HWA, pretty nice there, they're gonna have 2 TPs in Blazes there as well. And now Nias comes out, he has stolen the Fiend's Grip, but there's gonna be the Vacuum on top of him to cancel him. But he just left some Master Bricks, he's like, eh, yeah, you're gonna die here one way or the other. It's just a question of time, and ED knows it, and they're just not even gonna... try and help him out. Just leave him there. It's fine. Sometimes you just gotta accept it. Not always something to do about that. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Let's see what's the roll going up until now. It seems like hey, I've taken a bit of a lead. Over 5k right now, or around 5k at least in net worth, and over 4k in experience right now. They're gonna go for tier 1 push here on mid. That will expand their lead a bit more. If they can keep Charlie a bit more down, that would be nice. Who actually bought the Buckler and just sold it, like, okay, I need more HP and I just go for the Sunch. Surprising me a bit that he actually sold the Buckler. I don't see it in the base, and it's not on the courier either, so. Bit surprising me there that he did that. It's pretty weird. Like, just because they're, like, armor has a lot of value this game as well. Like, just having the Buckler for casual armor would help him out a lot. It's 7 armor if he activates it. And 2 of that, it goes to the entire team if they're close, so. Can surprise me, like, raw HP is nice as well with the mom coming out, but still, it's. I know, I would have. Still don't really get to sell there. He has an Aquila though, so he does have some kind of armor, but. He doesn't really have slots, like, that's the big problem, I guess. And they're spotted out here by the Hawk, so. This smoke is absolutely not gonna work out, and they're just gonna get a weave thrown on top of them as well. There we go, 3-4 man weave actually, and they just get pushed out with a deafening blast. Requiem Soul comes out as well, so Curse. Oh, ho, ho, 3-man vacuum there, but straight into an Omni Slash there coming out from HWA. Blaze has gotten his Aegis popped here, and he seems to be running away as Hey actually losing this fight so far. As Magoar was able to pick up the. Get the split going. Still pretty full HP as well. Nihis. Oh, he actually stole the split there. He goes into it. He's looking to turn his one around right now. Blaze, he got Shadow Graved up. He needs to take some distance here as he's pretty low on HP. Charlie gets up the Raisin Pelican, and there comes out the Tornado. Nice. Nice access coming down from German. He's still alive. Oh, just barely there. He's gonna get nice urn on top of him as well. Growl still fighting up there. Pelican taking a lot of damage. Doesn't have anything to save himself, but there's not enough damage right now. They're not following it up. He's gonna survive. And now Master Rex is gonna go down as well, but seemed to be a really good fight for EED. It's just still turning out terribly as they lose in the end. 3, I would say. Okay, this one's not gonna show up. So it's a 3-for-2 trade in the end. They did get the Aegis. I was actually expecting Hea to turn up a lot better in the beginning as he knew what was going on. They knew there was gonna smoke towards them. I expected them to group up a bit earlier, but it seemed like they just. Or better, at least be like more cohesive and just jump in together. But at the same time, doing it like this at least makes sure that you don't get like this 5-man curse and vacuum going off. It wasn't a 3-man vacuum. It was pretty devastating though, but it wasn't big enough to really turn it one around. They will get another tier 2 here as well. So at least they're taking something, not just the 3 kills. And you need a little bit more with the Aegis. It's already putting in some aggression here on the tier 3. Having these Necronomicons, it's just gonna do so much already. Just push it down, already down to half HP. It was just Alacrity here, they're just putting it on the Force Spirit right now. Oh, Nihis, he went forward here, he gets Maori in there, comes out the Omni Slash, going through it. There are a lot of creeps, so it's not doing enough. Oh, Nihis, he was caught with the curse, but there wasn't really enough follow-up there. So now Charlie has to run away. HWA is going to be fiend scripted up. They don't really have anything to stop it right now. Do they have a Shadow Wave? They do not. So that will be him down. Oh, they dodged the Sunstrike there. Now Blaze has to start running away. He's going to get searched up by Nihis and just goes Invis with the Ghost Walk. But there is already a Sentry out. They see him. And the split has been stolen here. Nihis again with big steals here. There's no vacuum right now coming out. He's still on cooldown for a long time. So they actually get nothing here with this wall. As they're just all positioned behind it, and the spirits are still going crazy here from these. Charlie is gonna get up the Rec Room finally, but still hasn't been able to get out of here. German players trying to fight it up, just keeping them there. They're gonna get a 2-for-2 trade so far. Now McGraw, he has been able to use the stick, getting a lot of that back, but still he's in the middle of them. They don't really have the damage right now to do anything back. He's gonna be cold and braced up, giving him a lot of HP, but still getting low at the same time. Oh, there comes that brain set, but there, Pelican, he has the Shallow Grave. Blaze, he needs to deal some damage. He's just hiding here. He's ready with the blink. It seems like they're just going to leave Nihis behind here with an armor on top of him. Pelican, he just lets himself get killed by the neutrals. It was actually buyback here by the Maui. I was not expecting that. Nihis. Ooh, Blaze is here now as well. He's on his own. They could jump him. They could just easily kill him here, and they're able to do so with the Force Spirits here coming from Blazeman, just getting those right clicks in with those. So with all that, I think in the end it should be a bit in favor of Hair, especially with the buyback there as well, and the dieback, essentially, on the Darkseer. Across, this is going to be the Agnims or the BKB? I think it's going to be the BKB. Will be the more normal build-up, I would say, there. Celery seems to be going for a 4-step, I would say, for himself as well. Just being able to force out the person as Rorks will really help you. And Sanjin Yasha completed on the Shadow Fiend, but at the moment that's all he has, so it's not really too much to speak of. Darkseer. He's trying to look to get his Blink Dagger there. 1k gold up, still 1.1k off there. Let's look at this German. He finds McGraw. They're gonna get up with Sunstrike here as well. He's taking a lot of damage. He dropped the Necrobooks as well. Is he gonna have enough damage here? They need some more hits in, but it's not gonna be enough as the mechanism comes out. And now German has to start running away. He popped the Necrobooks for this. So they might just want to try and go for a bit of a push here. It's just night. Just putting Nightmare on the Necrobook there. It's a nice tornado comes out with the follow-up. Yeah, they're gonna get a kill there. Nice follow-up there as well. Pretty well placed. The Gaze Meteor straight on top. Pretty easy. Getting the kill there on Bane. It's been not having the craziest of games so far, but not too much fun for them. Let's see what they're gonna do now. Blaze, he actually finished up the Blink there now, and he's got something else going. He's gonna be the BST, so he's just gonna go for this global thing. Oh, they just keep on going after McGraw here. They want him, but are they able to get him? There's a Blink on Blaze. Well, it's German here in the back. He doesn't have a roar for another 15 seconds. Spinning Blast is not going to connect off the boar. So, just going to get this tier 2 here. There's no fortification. And so just easily take this tower at the same time. Charlie's trying to go for a push here for himself as well. And he's going to get cold snapped up. They have more than enough control to keep him in place here. He's not able to TP out as there's too much damage as well. He goes down. Easy kill there. And they're at least able to get the tower. Like, that's something. Get a tier 2. Do pay what your position wants, so in the end, I don't really think it's worth it. Only if they can get like some item now up because of that on any of their supports. But Master Rex is not even close enough to get this Glimmer. And it didn't help complete up Bane's his 4-staff. And at least it brought Brewmaster pretty close to his BKB there, so at least that's something. But it's, I'm really doubtful it's enough. Mario hasn't been able to pick up the Blink Dagger straight over there either. Roshan is up now as well. And the side of Han do know it, so they just walk in and take it. So, watch out. Lot of minions here as well to help him out. And yeah, they're taking pretty damn fast here, I would say. They already got it now. This is the second Roshan of the game here. And it's gonna go straight onto Blaze again. He's 10-0-4 right now. He's just being like a crazy person on this Invoker. And he's been playing pretty damn well. As I want to remind everybody here, this is the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. This is for Save the Children Charity. Make sure to donate. There will show up a nice pop-up here, and they will also show it up into the widget over here, so make sure to do that. As you can also just go to savethechildren.org, as Master Rex is taking a lot of damage, but has been able to Arctic Burn away of the Meteor there, so he's gonna be fine for now. So they wanna go and push up into this high ground, but not really finding the good way to do it at the same time. McGraw is just pushing out on top here. They either need to commit, or give it up, because at this moment they're just taking damage on the tier 3 on top. Should be pretty much like go time, but the problem is that with Splinter Blast as well as the raises, it can easily take out the creep wave. So HWA is just gonna be on the front taking the damage here, but oh, the vacuum as well as the wall is actually gonna be whiffed here. As with Blaze TPing back, they're missing him, they need him. 30 seconds before he comes here. And it seems that McGraw just wants to go in. He gets the claps up, but there's the wall put down. Nicely stolen there by Neas. But there comes out the Curse, doing a lot of damage together with the Requiem of Souls. They get two kills here right now as HWA is down was the Beastmaster, not Pelican. He needs to shallow grave himself, but he's not going to be able to live here. He's just walking into them to make sure that they stay here, so to give Nihis some escape time. But Maori's on top of him. Oh, he steals the surge, he starts running away. And with the four stuff there, he's going to be fine. Now Blaze, he came in. He's looking to maybe try and clean this one up. How's he going to go at this? He just blinks in straight up on top of them. Oh, the combination. He's taking a lot of damage here on Celebrity. He just gets an easy double kill on top of them. And now he will just retreat. At least salvaging the fight somewhat. Making it a 2-for-3. He wants more. He goes in. Cold Snap is there. Mesmeric is able to just get off the Golden Brazen Nick of Time. But there is the Sunstrike from Blaze. And it's more than enough to kill him. And right now, just Blaze is just going absolutely crazy here. 13-0-4, man. This guy just doesn't want to die. Seems to be either going to be a Bloodstone or an Octarine Core for him. Both items, more than enough of you think. I would actually like to... I would like the Octarine Core more, though. Just having those lower cooldowns on your abilities is nice. Doesn't really mean too much for your Invoke ultimate, but still... It's already such a local now. Yeah, it's gonna be the flats finally picked up for McGraw here. So while it's going back for this with the BKB flats, gonna be an AC next most likely, or maybe the Abyssal Blade on him. So Basher, of course, into Abyssal. Pelican, is he? Okay, is he going back for a Crimson Card, or is it gonna be the Mecha? He can go like 2 rods with it. Yeah, Griefs are pretty good still. Pretty nice for yourself. Doesn't really dispel anything at the moment, but... Still, the lower cooldown always helps out. As the siege commences here again, and there's no split push at the moment coming out from ED. The Roar comes out here on Celery. Celery is dead. I think he got 4-step-4, didn't he? No, I'm not sure. Or was he called out? I think it was called out. Pretty weird that it was there. Anyhow, they just keep on going here. Tier 3 here on the bottom, down to over half HP here, and Blaze still has the Aegis. He has this for another... Well, 1 minute, so they kind of need to do something with this push, and with Bane down, they should be able to do so. But again, the Splinter Blasts are really annoying, as well as the races to get off everything here. Grow popped his BKB. And with that, there's no BKB for him in the upcoming fight, so if he jumps in, he needs to get off the ultimate straight away. If he gets lifted up, roared, or anything else funky, he's down. He's down for the count. Mesmeric, oh, Telekinesis up and thrown outside of the base. Oh, Splinter Blast got stone, but he has absolutely no money. He has to force himself him away. Oh, there comes the Vacuum as well as the curse with the Vacuum. They just had everything nicely on top of there. Blaze has to get the hell away from there. HWA has also been caught. He's going to go down. Only one surviving is Blaze. Do they have anything to find him here? No, he gets out. Same time in middle, German was able to stay out away from here. Oh, nice. Nice just right there. At least picking up Master Rix here. But terrible fight in the end for AS. They just got this three-man curse vacuum wall combination with... everything on top of there, just turning it into straight up 3 kills, and from there on they just easily won the fight. Nothing really for her to do against that apart from not being caught out. Same time Maui is gonna be fine. He's gonna die here. Nightmare, actually, what, that denied Maui. Oh, that's a fucking big play there coming out from Celery, and now they're gonna try and get German player, but Blaze, he came in, he has the Octarine Core ready, trying to get the damage in. Celery getting low, can he maybe nightmare himself here and deny himself? No, he can't. Blaze just picks up the kill. Do they want to go for McGraw? Seems so. But he buffs to BKB, and now Blaze like, okay, maybe not. I'll take a step back. Oh, he fights Charlie. Puts on Ice Wall, slowing him up. He needs to wait for reinforcements. Cold Snap comes out there as well. But there's going to be the BKB from Charlie. He's going to escape for now. It's just a race stolen here by Nihis. Nothing too special. Really good, Kimono. You know what the capital of Great Britain is? Mr. X thrown up, put back, but he just goes into the Glimmer and gets the hell out of there.
Zedras. It's gonna be the mecha into Greaves. So no Crimson Guard there. This also seems more like the normal build-up, I would say.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, there was an aggressive blink forward from Grawl here, and he goes straight into the split. He needs to find someone here. But Azobia, he can just spin and run away for now. They need to find German and lift him up into the air. They will do so, but there's no follow-up for this right now. It's everybody has just escaped, and this split in the end is just going to be worthless and not really getting anything with it. Force that forward. Yeah, he's going to get... He at least finds Azobia and puts him into the air for some time, but it's not really enough. As Nii's been able to steal something more useful than a race. No, he's still stuck in that. I don't think he likes that too much. As now with split down, they just go for an easy tier 2. Nothing really to stop them there, as they even find Master Rix. He was too far out of his base. Pretty much just got out of position there. So no courage for the base hold here, so they're already down two big ultimates. And both are about 40 to 50 seconds down. So, getting into damage on the tower now. Drunken Haze coming out. As the old Vacuum comes out on two, but the wall has not been popped. And now Vacuum has been stolen by Nii's and just pulls three in there. And there comes out the Omnis is going through Charlie. He's been eaten up alive. They lose four. And now they're going to get in some damage here. McGraw is trying to do something here, but he's fighting up against Blaze. And I don't really think he will win this, especially with Pelican coming in. He just needs to leave this for now. They get the tier 3 on mid. Top is also getting low. Just trying to do as much structural damage as they can. Still 50 seconds without the Shadow Fiend. And he DC'd and they just call GG. They don't think they can hold anymore. And against a 15-0-7 Invoker, well, I can understand it really, really much. This is just really an outstanding performance, especially from Blaze. Of course, from the like, there were some misses, but they tried to go into the base. But you know, it's always hard against the Vacuum Wall with Curse, Requiem. Like, it's there's a lot of team fight from ED, but it was not enough. Hey, pick up the game here. This is game one, so ED they can still come back, win two games, go to the lower bracket round two. But that said, hey, they're on the match point here now. This is this Mount Hermon charity tournament for Save the Children. Make sure to donate. As well as I'm @Center_Dota. We'll see you guys all back after the break for game number 2.